Being a healer in New World is a job that is both rewarding and difficult, depending on what you're doing. Hello, people of the internet. My name is Mags, and today we're going to be talking about the ins and outs of being a good healer. I'm going to be going over leveling, gear, skills, rotations, and quirks while we are in the early days of New World so that you can be a boon to any environment and team. As a caveat, please note that the information that I'll provide today is not ironclad. Meaning there are certain skills and things that might work better for you at the end of the day, depending on your team composition and what you are doing. So it's up to you to experiment as you see fit. Let's get into the video. When you're starting your journey in New World as a healer, you will suck at literally everything. The life staff does minimal damage and scales horrifically compared to all other weapons in the game. So for your first few levels, I would recommend getting yourself an offhand weapon that can give you a little breathing room. For this, you should consider using a weapon that scales off a single stat. These will include Great Axe, Hammer, Ice Gauntlet, Fire Staff, etc. The idea here is that you'll be able to use the benefits that these weapons will have early on and allow yourself to level your life staff along the way. The only outlier to this list would be the Hatchet, which handles itself very nicely with the Berserk perk and pairs really, really well with the life staff even into the endgame. We won't talk too much about offhands as I plan to make a separate video about it in the near future, but for now, just get something that can do some damage. When you're leveling in New World, there are a few things that I'm going to suggest you stick to for the long haul. The first of these is to sink every single attribute point you get into focus. The focus attribute is the only one that our life staff scales off of, and it's important to get those large heals out and become, well, virtually unkillable. The other attribute we're going to want is constitution, which will increase your health pool, but you can easily manage this through gear drops you get around the world. In the early game, while you're leveling, be on the lookout for gear with focus or constitution, or both, as attributes to best help you along your leveling journey. For now, let's head over to the skill tree and talk about what skills you're going to want to take to get the most bang for your buck in terms of healing. For this, I'm going to be using the skill builder over on New World Database. Each weapon in New World has 19 total skill points that you can use across two different skill trees. For the life staff, these two trees are the healing tree and the protector tree. Most of your points are going to be put into the healing tree as the passive nodes from this side will increase your healing output massively, which is what we want. You want to start out by snagging the first passive, Absolved. This is going to eliminate the mana cost for light and heavy attacks, which is a must. Next up, I would recommend getting your first skill, Sacred Ground. Sacred Ground is going to be the skill that you will use most often and is the best AoE heal available in the game. Your next point should be spent maxing out all of the passives beneath Sacred Ground. This is going to include Holy Ground and Blessed. Holy Ground is going to increase stamina and mana generation for anyone within Sacred Ground, allowing your tanks to keep tanking and your mages to stay topped off on mana. Blessed allows those in Sacred Ground to benefit from 50% more healing from all healing. This means potions, lifesteal abilities, food buffs, and yes, even more healing from your own abilities. With Sacred Ground maxed out, we can get the passive Intensify. This is going to increase the healing output from all of your abilities by 10% for 10 seconds, and it stacks up to 3 times. So you can get off 3 heavy attacks, and that's an automatic 30% more healing that you're going to be doing. Then you can simply spam light attacks until your timer gets low, and then throw in another heavy attack to refresh your timer. From here, we're going to want to switch over to the Protector tree and pick up Bend Light. This is going to increase your healing output by 20% for 5 seconds after you dodge, bringing your total bonus healing as of right now with the points you have allocated as a 100% increase. After you pick up Bend Light, it's time to get your second ability, Beacon. Beacon is a great way to place heals on your tank or directly on the enemy so that tanks and melee teammates can benefit from that AoE healing. Sacred Ground and Beacon together can easily full heal a tank in battle and can keep you alive during those large AoE mob pulls. After we snag Beacon, we want to get its first and second passives for the increase to Beacon size as well as the duration. From this point, we're going to focus on adding passives to increase the percentage of healing we do and, you know, add some additional benefits. These are going to include Revitalize for the cooldown reduction on light attacks, Blissful Touch for healing while shooting through our teammates, Protector Strength for the 10% increase to healing if you have a buff applied on yourself, which does include food buffs, Mending Touch for the ability to cleanse debuffs with our heavy attacks, especially damage over time abilities like Bleed, Burn, Disease, etc. Sacred Protection for the 5% increase to all incoming healing to friendlies. And we'll take Desperate Speed for the increase to cooldown reduction if you heal someone below 50%. At this point, you should be able to purchase the capstone ability in the healing tree, Divine Blessing. This is going to make those heals to teammates that have less than 50% get an additional 30% more healing. As our final point spends here, you're going to want to either take Orb of Protection or Light's Embrace. An argument can be made for both of these abilities in terms of their usefulness as well as the situations you can use them in. In the build that I run 90% of the time, I take Light's Embrace without the passives underneath it. Light's Embrace is a great way to put out huge heals on yourself or your team. And in most cases that I use it, it results in a full heal because it will heal 100% of your weapon damage and then an additional 30% for each buff your target has, which does include yourself as well. This skill is best used as an oh no button if your tank is getting mobbed by a boss or if you accidentally take aggro and need a way to heal yourself while letting your teammates stay in sacred ground. The only time I would maybe take Orb over Light's Embrace is in the case of PvP or war scenarios. Single target healing usually isn't going to be as helpful as applying an AoE heal and some fortify on your teammates, so consider running Orb for those scenarios. If you do plan on taking Orb of Protection, I would only take the first passive. This is going to increase recovery, which increases the healing that your teammates receive, and is probably the best benefit of having Orb in the first place. The recovery by itself really isn't that great, but if you pair it with something like Beacon and Sacred Ground, all of a sudden your teammates are being able to get massive heals from those two other abilities. Finally, the last points are for you to spend however you want. If you wanted to, you could even spend the point on Light's Embrace so you can freely switch between healing in PvP or PvE for a super versatile build. The only nodes I would probably stay away from are going to be Enchanted Justice. It's great in theory, but really bad in practice, with a super long cooldown, and it is 100% not worth it. I would also say that Protector's Touch and Balance are not worth it either, because their buffs are limited in usage and time, and we have armor and weapon perks that do those jobs, and much, much better. So we can completely skip those. By mid to late game, you should be starting to see some better gear drops and have access to things like faction gear, as well as more attribute points to play with overall. While you're leveling, you should be sinking every point you get into focus, but the other attribute points will come from your gear or food buffs. Gear is usually separated into affixes, and those affixes actually have stat splits depending on what the affix is. For healers, I would recommend going with gear that has the affix of the sentry for straight constitution, of the cleric for a focus constitution split with focus being the main stat, or of the nomad for a constitution focus split with constitution being the main stat. The underlying goal here is to supplement your constitution or your total health via your armor stats or jewelry. This should help you in getting to your endgame split of 250 focus and 100 constitution. This split, in my opinion, is a foundation of a solid tanky healer because of the breakpoint benefits that we get. Each 50 points into a single attribute will reward you with a bonus perk of some sort. Since we're maining focus, those benefits are 10% mana regen at 50 points, plus 20 to our mana pool at 100 points, plus 20% to our healing output at 150 points, which is huge, plus 20% on casted buffs at 200 points, and finally at 250 points, we get 30 mana back on any self or group kill. This is great for being able to spam abilities, especially with the low cooldowns we get just from using our light attacks. Once you hit 250 focus, there isn't a reason to go much further, as this game does have diminishing returns. It's at this point I would place everything else you have into constitution, at least until you reach 100 points. This is because the first two breakpoints are an increase to healing consumable strength, which will stack with your bonus healing, and at 100 points, you get an additional 10% health based off your physical armor. After you reach these point values, the rest is completely up to you. If you want to be more tanky, you can even move 50 points from focus into constitution and give yourself a 200-200 split. Need a little more DPS? Use your remaining points to sink into the main stat of your offhand. This should give you plenty of damage against mobs while you're solo leveling. The sky really is the limit beyond this. You just have to make sure you're wearing the right gear. And on that note, let's talk about armor. Armor in New World has three weight categories: light, medium, and heavy. These sets have different bonuses depending on what you have. For light armor, you receive a 20% bonus to damage and healing output. For medium armor, you receive a 10% bonus to damage and healing output, as well as a 10% duration to crowd control abilities. And finally, for heavy armor, you receive a 20% buff to crowd control abilities. Like the weight suggests, the heavier armor that you wear, the more resistance that armor has to both physical and elemental damage. Also, each of these armor weights has a different dodge animation. Light armor gets two dodges in the form of dodge rolls, medium gets three in the form of sidesteps, and heavy gets two side lurches. So the question is, which one should you pick? Well, remember when I said light and medium give you a boost to healing? That is bugged AF currently. Not to mention, light armor is a great way to get one shot in endgame content, so that is pretty much out of the window. At least for now, until they fix things. For armor, I would strongly suggest going for full heavy armor, especially in endgame content. This is going to give you the max amount of protection in any scenario, be it war, outpost rush, dungeon content, or even just rolling through Murkguard. If you absolutely hate the dodge animation on heavy armor, or they manage to fix the healing output issue on the other armors, I would strongly suggest going with the max weight in the medium class. There are a few ways to mix and match armor to get this split, and I would recommend your chest and legs be heavy, and then you can use a mixture of light and medium on your other pieces. This is mainly because chest and pants usually offer the highest level of physical and elemental resistance, so you're gonna get the most bang for your buck there. This should give you a solid start to building your New World healers and prepare them to take on the game as a tanky all-arounder, with the ability to outheal most damage. If you also run a life staff and you have some tips for your fellow healers, be sure to share them in the comments section below. But that's gonna do it for me. As always, I'm Mags, and I will see you in the next one.